This time and yield to the distinguished gentleman from Florida, my partner, Mr. Mica.
I thank you, Chairman, and also for our mutual efforts to try to hold everybody's feet to the fire on Congress's intent in getting people working and some of the stimulus money out. Now, for our committee, of course, when we passed the $787 billion stimulus package, most folks thought that 90%, 80%, 70% of that would be for infrastructure and that we would deal with our nation's crumbling highways, bridges, ports, airports, the roads they go over daily, and they'd see dramatic improvements. As it turned out, Mr. Oberstar and I were only able to get about 7% of that entire package for infrastructure. One of the reasons we couldn't get it was because they said it's very, well, it was a CBO that scored it, and they said that they could only get out $63 billion in the time allotted.
Would the gentleman yield?
Yes.
They actually said we could only spend out at a rate of 2.4%.
Okay, well.
And they were wrong.
In any event, we got an agreement to get out $63 billion, I think, under our purview. Which is a small percentage of the total package. One of my concerns then, one of my concerns now, today, and one of my concerns for the future is the problem of government red tape, government bureaucracy, government hoops. Now, we tried to send the money to the states to distribute it in an orderly fashion, and our intent was not to pick project winners and losers, right, Mr. Oberstar, but to do it in an orderly fashion. The problem is we're getting strangled with, again, with government red tape, with bureaucracy. Now, of the $48 billion, and I prepared a little minority report on, this is our 120-day report, and asked our staff to put together where, you know, where's the money? Let's follow the money. Well, we had $48 billion given to the Department of Transportation. Now, as of May 29th, the amount obligated was $15.7 billion. Now, DOT, and I've gotten two update reports. One was the end of May, the first day of June. We only had $154 million in outlay. That's real work being done out of $48 billion. Now, I have the latest update, and we'll probably get this from the administrator today. $369 million. Folks, that's just pennies on a dollar, fractions of a penny on a dollar of what we've made available. Now, don't say that Mica is saying that we're mired in red tape. Let me just give you a sampling of commentary that I have, and apart from the public record. Norwalk, Connecticut, Mayor Richard Bosia said after a mayor's conference, we really need to talk about eliminating some of the bureaucratic things that Washington forces on the states. He's talking about this, why he can't move forward with a stimulus package. Missouri DOT Director Pete Rands, this is what he said, federal requirements have been taken to a new level. We're going to have to dedicate additional staff even to the record keeping and auditing required under these new procedures. Madison, I guess this is Madison, Wisconsin MPO informed their locality about the difficulty in getting money dispersed for projects. Ironically, it won't do much for job creation this year because the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act requires piles of red tape to get federal funding, and it'll delay people going to work for you. Now, I'm just giving you a small sampling of what they're telling us as far as the difficulty in getting people to work. I've been home, folks. I've got a lot of folks hurting. Florida just went over 10%, double-digit unemployment. Nationally, we're now at 9.4%. I have one county with 15% unemployment. Not one person asked me to come to Washington and pass some more red tape. People want jobs, and they want them now. So finally, in this report, and it's not included in the back of the report, but I think we've distributed these to members, and we've taken the figures provided by DOT. You can see the outlays, the unemployment rate in each of the states, and also the amount of money, again, that has been expended. What I did is, on this particular chart here, these are the top 10 highest unemployment state, including the District of Columbia, and it shows the amount of outlay as of, that would be June 1st on this particular one, $11 million. Folks, this is pitiful that we cannot get people working, we can't get the stimulus money out, and we're tied up in red tape and bureaucracy, and we've created that. So we've got to do something, Mr. Oberstar, members on this committee, to figure out a way to get people working the jobs and cut the red tape right now under stimulus, and in the long term under the bill that is under consideration for reauthorization for the next 6 years. So I thank our witnesses, look forward to hearing from them. Some have done an excellent job. Mr. Babbitt's going to report on successes from FAA, and I know they're trying, but their main constraint, their main problem, and you guys know it, and there's a couple of gals that aren't speaking, but you all know it. The main problem is right here, Congress. So hopefully we can figure out a way to help you do your job and get this money out quicker and get people to work faster. Yield back the balance.